H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So from here, we can create a new validation rule, or else I should go on setup. Then opportunity. And then validation rule. The same script. These were the things which were introduced in 2-3 years. At the starting point, we do not have that. We just click on the icon here and we get the validation rule here. Mm-hmm. So now I will tell you from starting how the Salesforce works. Mm-hmm. In Salesforce, what we have that, for example, I am my organization is using some sales representatives are there, and they want to sell their product or something. And for that, how we do in alerting if Salesforce is not there? I have created some new product and I want customers to use them. But how you will do, you will advertise for that this product has these much features and you should go on and buy this. These all things were done earlier as well when the Salesforce was not in picture. But with the manual, we go for campaigns in the we arrange the seminars for this, for introducing my product. Sometimes we give the ad in the ad for the TV or the ad for the TV so that most of the people are aware of my product and they should use that. But for maintaining that how I have created a campaign, there was nothing. We were storing everything in the Excel. That was the manual process. That if we are doing campaign on the one side, we need to mention that in Excel. For one product, I have done 5 types of campaigns. I have given ads in TV, I have arranged seminars, I have gone to different companies for introducing my product. So there are 3 types there. What I have done 3 types of campaigning, and for that I have created Excel and I have stored everything. But in Salesforce, what we can do? We can create a new campaign. We can provide the campaign name here. For example, I have given ad in television. It is the active campaign if I am using. I can select webinar, trade show, public relations, that what is the mode of my campaign. So the mode of my campaign is advertisement. Status. Now, storing everything in Excel and remembering everything for what I have created Excel, for the one thing they need to store, for one thing they need to create 10 or 20 Excels, and they have to remember that why they are using these Excels. But we can...
So in the drop-down, the drop-down has few things, right? Status, I click on type. Yes. So does the Salesforce enforces what options should be listed in this dropdown, or as developer or admin, someone put the list in the dropdown?
Yeah, Salesforce has provided the standard things. Mm-hmm. In the type, it has provided me these much options that I can go for this. But if as an admin, as a developer, I want, and my mode of campaigning is different than the options which are there, then I can create, increase options here. I would go to on this. This is a very important thing Otherwise, again, we need to go to setup and then we need, I will show you both the steps. I'm going here. I will remember the name of the field. It is type.
Yeah. And are we recording this session? Because if I want to practice later on or something.
No, we are not recording.
This session is being recorded. Yeah, I see that. This session is being recorded. Okay, that's
good. Yeah. I will search here for the type. Type field is here. I will click on this. These are the options which you were able to see on the UI. I want some new thing here. For example, I've written telephone. This is my mode of campaigning. And if you check earlier, it is these were the things present there. So I want to add it. I would add telephone and I would save this. So when now you will check, telephone would be the part of this. And here, what you will see that this option is also present there. See, telephone is there.
Yeah.
So you can increase or decrease whatever. Now I don't want telephone to be there. I would click on deactivate.
Okay.
And it would go to the section behind in inactive values.
Yeah. So it will have a placeholder for the telephone in case you want to make it active. It later on, right? Instead
yes.
of deleting it.
If you so again some time yeah. back your requirement changes and you want to again add this telephone, you can add it here. Because I can delete as well.
Yeah, right.
We should delete when we are completely sure that in future this would not come again.
Right.
Otherwise it would increase our effort. Again, I would have to create this checklist value. So for the every drop down, for these drop down in Salesforce, what we say pick list value.
What is it?
Pick list, P-I-C-K-L-I-S-T.
Okay.
So in general layman language, this is a field of type drop down, but in a Salesforce, we say this is a pick list field.
Okay.
The same thing goes for status as well, that if we want to increase this status, again the step would be the same. We would go to the campaign fields, we will search for the status. And we will click on the status.
So I should be also able to see all these options, right?
Yes, yes. Okay. I haven't changed anything here. But if I would change that, then you would be able to see. You have to change in your personal log, then you can see that what changes you have done.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And from the same way, see, I'm planning for that, and I know my campaign would start from 13th of December and it would end something near about 31st. So I would give these dates, but I want some more fields to be entered here, which I am not able to see here. But my requirement is I want to see some more fields here. For example, if I want to use some
flexibility name or something.
Yeah, then we can create a new field as well. The same process would be there.
Under parent campaign, let's say, for example, if we want to have a city field, so we should be able to add that city.
Yeah, we would be able to create that field. See, here, these are the standard fields. In Salesforce, we have two things, standard field as well as custom field. Standard fields are those fields which are provided by the Salesforce for everyone. Custom fields are those fields which, as a developer, as an admin, as a user, I want to use that field.
Yeah, adding little more to the standard.
So I can add that field under this. And then we can provide the data type. So for example, we need to create a city field. The city field would be the text one. Or if you want, you can provide the options that you have provided 5 city names, and from that the user need to select, then we can create a pick list also, drop down.
But this is so hands-on compared to Java.
Actually, in Java, everything is related to coding thing. In this coding thing is there, but this is the starting part, starting phase of the Salesforce, where we do not need to touch for any. In Java also, in UI page, if you want to create a field, you have to write a code, right? So in Salesforce they have provided few things, just a drag and drop, and we can create that.
Right. So at least the developer can have a skeleton without much effort, and then they can improvise.
And for the user also, this is helpful, because for creating 5 fields in the UI with the code, it would take much time.
Okay, field label, okay, length, field name.
So in field label I can provide city, length. For every field what we create in Salesforce, we have the limits for that. That also link I will share. For the text field, it's 225 or 255, something like that. I will share that cheat sheet with you.
Yeah, that's the max, right?
Yeah, I'm giving the 18. So my text to that characters should not increase by 18. If it is, we have 19 characters in the city, it would not allow you to save the record.
Okay.
I would take less, then I would show you that how it.
So if we want to say only the characters are allowed and not the numbers or something, what you would do?
See, if it's a text field, that I will show by show you by creating validation rule as well. But from for now, you can check. I have created a text field. So in Salesforce, they have provided us the data types, and they have defined the exact value what you can take in that. This is a text field. If we can store anything here, number as well. But after this, I will create a validation rule that if it takes number, then it should not allow the user to save a record. So if you want to make this field mandatory on the UI, and for the mandatory on UI, you can see. You would be able to see like this. This red sign is the symbol which indicates that this field is mandatory.
Okay.
So if you, I want to use this required, then I can do unique. This is a, this does not allow duplicate values. For example, I have created one campaign with this with the city test, And now I am creating a second campaign, mm-hmm. again with the city test. It would not allow us to save the record.
Yeah, just it will check for the duplicate.
Yeah. And this is mainly used in the whenever we are importing data into Salesforce.
Okay.
For that, from the third party system, mm-hmm. if we are using some data, then this is required that field should be unique. External ID, this is also the same thing.
Whenever when we are importing the records, you said, right?
Yeah.
Duplicate values.
Yeah. Whenever we are using any external system, mm-hmm. and they have some one field which is unique to them.
Yeah.
So in Salesforce, we have the ID thing. We can mm-hmm. cross-verify with that. But if we are taking the data from the third-party external system and we are importing this in Salesforce, then mm-hmm. we should have one field, because they would not get for those records, we would not have ID before. After right. that, we have that ID once mm-hmm. we data load that data. But before yeah. data loading, we do not have that ID. So we right. have one field, which is external ID field or unique, then we can do that. And for the external mm-hmm. ID field, there are only three data types, text, number, email, which we can take. I will show you all the data types, how it works.
So what is the difference? I didn't get it. Unique and external, because unique is also not allowing the duplicate values, right? And external is yeah. also, it says it doesn't allow the duplicate values.
Yeah. For the for the unique field, I can take any data type.
Uh-huh.
It can okay. be text, it can be text area, anything.
Okay.
But for the external ID field, I can only three types of data types are allowed in this: text, number, email. Rest all we cannot take in external ID. If you want phone number to be taken as an external ID field, it would not allow you.
Okay, text, email, and the I number.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, these are the three.
Yeah.
Actually, for this, I would share many things. Would you? And this is the thing what it is asking, that for which profile you want to see this field, or for some profiles you do not want user to change this, then you can click here.
Mm-hmm.
Now I will go to the next. This is the same way you can create field in any of the objects.
Okay.
Tomorrow I will explain you the difference between the objects and the fields and how we relate it.
Yeah.
So that you would be much aware of that why we use that.
Yeah. Not sure if Daniel has mentioned to you or not, but before next Thursday, we have to complete 10 hours. So just want to let you also know, because I think he was...
Before Thursday.
Because...
21st.
Yeah, before next Thursday. Yes.
Okay.
Because after that, I'll be on vacation, and there is another person who will be training before I come, and then we'll be continuing both.
Okay. So it would be okay. We would be taking 2 hour session, so it would be done.
Yeah.
That is not a problem.
We can do 2 hour session.
Yeah. So now when I click on campaign, I would be able to see that city field as well. See, and I have made it required.
Yeah.
So this field is there.
That's why it's like coming with the red. Okay.
Yes. You can select any date here. That depends completely on the business.
Mm-hmm.
Expected revenue in campaign, I want 40,000. You can fill all the fields like that.
Mm-hmm.
City I have filled, and I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
Then I will show
so
you
it
how
doesn't
the
connect to any external database or anything, right? All the information.
No, it doesn't connect. If we want some external data from the third party system to be migrated to the Salesforce. Mm-hmm. What we have some tools like a data loader, mm-hmm. or import or export, how mm-hmm. there, if records are less than 50,000, we can do straight away from this UI.
Okay.
That all I will see. This was a text field and it has taken 1, 2, 3, 4.
Uh-huh.
But I do not want this field should take 1, 2, 3, yeah. 4. It should mm-hmm. not take numbers. Mm-hmm. Then I would create a validation rule for here.
Mm.
This I will show you tomorrow. And I will explain you every what is the difference between the standard object and the custom object, standard yeah. fields and the custom fields. So that yeah. you would be much aware of the screen, how it works and why we use this.
Right, right. Yeah. And if you and can, if I thing, share my screen and if you can just, are you done with what you're just trying to say?
Yes, yes. Tell me.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to share my screen and
okay.
So if I want to see the campaign, where I should go?
But I'm not able to see your screen actually. Wait, I will change presenter to you.
Yeah, are you able to see the Salesforce?
Yeah, actually, you were these all things I will explain you tomorrow, but you have to make me that. I do not have access of where the site.com is written. That is the drop down, right? Okay. In the right side.
One second.
Next to your yeah. name. Yeah. Click mm-hmm. on that mm-hmm. and click on sales.
Sales.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Campaign. Next to chatter. I will explain you tomorrow that how, what is this drop down, and then we yeah. need to select this, everything that I will explain you.
Sure. Yeah.
So now you can play with somewhat with campaign.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
By creating new fields, everything. Yeah. Then I would yeah. explain you how to create a validation rule on that. And there are a few more things which we can do on this. And if you get one object, how it works, rest all objects work in the same way.
Okay. So to yeah. To just see that campaign list, yeah, the drop down, the pick values and all that.
Yeah, click on new, recent, next to recent campaigns, not there.
Mm.
You are able to see campaign.
Create a new view.
Yeah, this is for the
campaigns.
Yeah, click on this new, yeah, click.
Okay. Yeah,
yeah, and you can so create field values here and save here. Then I will show you a rest of the screen, how it works and why it is there.
Mm-hmm. Save and new and how we went somewhere, right? To some place to
yeah.
add more type. Where, how yes, do yes. I go yeah. there?
In the right side, you have a quick mm-hmm. access menu. It's just like an arrow. Help below that, help for this page is there. Below that,
mm-hmm.
there is one arrow next to required information. There is one arrow icon.
Mm-hmm.
Just
see that
to the right of the required information.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Click on this arrow thing, symbol. This is the fastest thing we can do from here. If you want to go to the fields, you can click here, view fields. Yeah, scroll it. Yes, scroll it, then you would be able to see that custom thing. Yeah, this campaign custom fields and it's a heading, like there we have option of new. There you can click and you can create a new field. Scroll down. Yeah, here you can. For today, just practice for text. I will explain you all the things that how it works. What are the data types? then you can get go for the next as well.
Yeah. No, so I just what is an object? Because in Java, everything is an object. So what in Salesforce, what does object means?
Campaign. This campaign whole as a whole is an object.
Okay. Okay. But not the, like the if we create a text field like city or something, that is not
that
an object.
Is a field inside the object.
Okay.
How we have rows and columns in the object, right?
Yeah.
It is okay. The same thing.